So we get a lot of questions when it comes to generic code, right? Now there's an online version and then there is a desktop version. And you know, the price difference is pretty big between the two. The desktop version is a little under $700 and the online version is $100 per year. And I totally get it, right? It's a hard decision to make, right? If you buy the desktop version for a little under $700, then you're gonna be able to access it forever on your computer. You don't have to buy any updates if you don't want to, and you can just use it, right? At the same time, using the online version allows you to have access wherever you're at on your cell phone by just logging into their website. Really convenient, and you always get the most up-to-date information. So it can kind of be, you know, this toss-up, like which one is better? And a lot of people actually even use both. But so what I want to do in this video is just give you a side-by-side comparison to help you make the best decision that you can. So this is the desktop version here, okay? This is what's gonna look like when you click on the little icon and you open it up. In the notes below, I'm gonna have a link to both the desktop version and the online version that you can check out. And what I wanna do is I want to show you what it looks like to look up a code in this. Let's go and look up a code really quick. All right, let's look up 1706X. It's a Ford code, all right. So I'm gonna go here to vehicle. All right, so this is what the screen's gonna look like. It's gonna give you all the, you know, the code series information, some little bit of information about it, the key blank part number, as well as like the type, all right? So let's go ahead and just click on it. All right, so this is what you're really going to be looking at, right, when you're doing any sort of code work. So you have the code, you put it in, and you're gonna pull up this information, and it's gonna give you all the stuff you need to know. Now, I'm just gonna skim over some of it. I'll put a link in the notes below to some videos that we've done that are more in depth, all right, so you can dive in here, but I really wanna do a side-by-side comparison here for you. So you'll see here, you'll see all this information, right? There's the cuts, there's the spacing, there's the depths. And then over here, what's important, right? So like for HPC, if you have an HPC like Blitz machine, you can print cards inside of this program. All you have to do is hit the print card button, make card button, and there you go. You can print that out and it's a done deal. So that's really convenient, really nice. And especially on the, you know, the vehicles or on different locks that there's not a card that comes with the package of cards when you buy a machine. Being able to, instead of using the micrometer card, be able to print a card is super convenient. So down here at the bottom, you're gonna see these, you know, cuts to code, search and series, all right? These are very important things to go ahead and do if you're gonna be decoding the lock and trying to find the missing bidding, all right? So that's what this looks like. All right, it has a picture of the key blank information, cross-reference, all of that fun stuff. So that's what it's gonna look like when you open up a code inside of the generic code desktop version, all right? Now let's go to the online. All right, so this is what the online version looks like after you log in, all right? You're gonna see up here at the search at database, all right? So that's what I was talking about earlier, is you're gonna see these options, what are the exact same options as the desktop version, and then you're gonna see your key blank cross-reference there. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna do the same exact thing. We're gonna type in 1706X, all right? We're gonna go to vehicle. Hit search. Okay, it's gonna have the same exact information. Now it looks a little different, but you're gonna see the exact same information here. We'll click on view details. Okay, so as you can see, this right here has all of the same information, but it just looks a little different, right? You're gonna have the details, the cuts, the spaces, the depths, the key blank cross-reference, the cuts to code, search and series, as well as the ability, which is really important, you know, to look up the machine information, and with HPC in particular, you can go ahead and print the code card if you need to. So that's really the difference between the two, okay? So when it comes to all the standard stuff that you're going to be wanting to do as far as looking up codes, all of that is gonna be the same between the desktop version and the online version. All right, so on the desktop version, I'm gonna show you a couple things that I find very helpful that are not in the generic code online version, okay? Now, like I said, all the essentials are in both. All the essentials are in both, but stuff like this equipment machinery. Something really cool about that is, you know, you're gonna get customers that are gonna call you up and they're gonna have a Bobcat or they're gonna have some sort of equipment that they need a key for. And a lot of times, until you get a lot of experience, it can be very difficult to figure out what it is. Right? It might be sitting outside of your shop or sitting on a job site and, you know, the customer needs help. And so to go out there and be like, man, it's hard to know what to do, what to look for. Using this screen here can be so helpful, okay? And for example, if we're looking at Bobcat right here, you can kind of go through and you can start looking at what type of keys are used for Bobcat, as well as you can see the code series there. So why that's important is that when you go out there, maybe there's a code on the face of the lock. All right, well, you're gonna automatically know, have more information to deal with it. Same with the picture. Sometimes a picture of maybe a customer's existing key, or when you look down in the profile, it can be fairly easy to kind of narrow down, right, if it's a single-sided key or a double-sided key based on the positioning, or if there's wafers on both sides, or if maybe it's on one, but you can see like the two groove patterns. That information can be very helpful. So to really leave you with a couple thoughts that might help you make an informed decision. The first one's gonna be is it important to you to always have up-to-date information, right? With the online version, you know, it's a yearly $100 fee and every year you pay it, but at all times you're gonna have the most up-to-date information that you can use on your phone, make it super simple. At the same time, you buy the desktop version. If you don't want to ever update it, you don't have to, and you don't have to incur any additional costs. So that can be very nice. At the same part, if you want to stay up to date on all the new code series coming out, well, that's going to be a problem. But I really think a lot of it just comes down to convenience. Do you like to, on your phone, find the basic information and get the job done? Or do you want to have to pull out your Windows device and look it up that way? So there's good use cases for both options. I really hope this is helpful. I would love to know in the comments below what you think about the two applications and what one that you prefer. And make sure you include the hashtag Lockboss to automatically get entered in to win one of 5 free prizes we give away every week on YouTube on Tuesday. Thank you for watching. We'll see you next time.